engine fires for 12 minutes.
Just thinking, I think this is the first burn in the vicinity of the moon that's on this side.
Hey, Stigman, camera coming on.
First descent propulsion system burn on this side.
No, any burn of any magnitude at all. See, all of our corrective burns are on the back side of the moon.
Oh, yes, that's right. On Apollo 10, they came on up to apogee and then fired to go into the... That's right. And by that time, they're on the far side again.
Eagle Houston, if you'd like to try high gain pitch 212, yaw 37, over.
We've got a minute and a half.
Roger, I think I've got you on high gain now. Roger. Coming up on
1 minute
to ignition.
1 minute to ignition and 13 minutes to landing.
Can you get any angles, though? I'll let them in to use them before we yaw around. Roger, pitch 212, yaw plus 37.
Don't know that we could take the tension if they decide to go around again.
Arm descent.
40 seconds.
Number.
30 seconds.
Cut altitude about 46,000 feet, continuing to descend.
I'm just wondering, as Newell Trask is sitting here with us, how the moon looks to him as we're coming over. Do you think that's the right place?
Yes, that looks like the right place.
We should have a countdown now.
Ignition
10%. 10% throttle, I suppose that is. Wally?
Yes, it'll be programmed up as we, as they get closer to the surface. I think you have that data there. Yes.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Maybe we're having a little ionic disturbance from the engine at this point. No problem, just the fact that it might be trouble getting communications through the plume.
Well, it would mean then that we would not have communication with them in this critical 12 minutes. Animation shows the engine firing.
Oh, good.
The lunar module is proceeding from right to left on your screen.
I'll leave it in flu. Relay to us. See if they got me now. I got good signal strength in flu.
Yeah, you should have me now, Houston.
Eagle, we got you now. It's looking good. Over. Eagle,
that
looks good. Eagle, Houston, everything's looking good here. Over.
I think you can hear a little excitement in Charlie
Roger,
Duke's
copy.
Voice.
Eagle, Houston, after yaw around, angled S-band pitch, minus niner, yaw plus 1/8. Copy.
Yeah, communications are in really good shape again.
I can bring the degree very closely. Roger.
Great.
10 minutes to the touchdown. Oh, boy. 10 minutes to a landing on the moon.
Right on. Altitude's a little high.
I think it's been almost 10 years since we've been trying to do this.
Now just
2 minutes, 20 seconds, everything looking good. We show altitude about 47,000 feet.
Yeah.
Now in about 4 minutes from now, they will get their first look at the landing area. So far, now, their heads are down.
They're getting a little fluctuation in the AC voltage now. Roger.
They're,
50 meter maybe, huh?
They are face down, looking windows down.
You're still looking good at three, coming up 3 minutes.
Their feet forward.
That remark on that AC voltage was a meter possibly. The ground is not concerned with it.
Looks so good.
They rolled now through the windows up position.
Position check down range to us to be a little long.
As you just saw. In about 3 minutes now, they get that first look when they pitch up, going to a more of an upright position. And they can look forward out their windows toward the landing site. At that point, they'll be about 3.5 miles high, making about 103 miles an hour forward with about 13 8/10 miles to go.
It's
going to stop. 7 minutes, 45 seconds to landing.
You're a go to continue power descent. You're a go to continue power descent.
That's another major milestone.
Altitude 40,000.
This is a
go. Houston, we got data dropout. You're still looking good.
Go, no go decision at that point. They could abort the landing at that point if there had been a no go decision. Got about 68 miles to go. Seven minutes left before landing.
Okay, we got good lock on.
They're at about 35.
Altitude lights out.
35,000 feet high now.
LH is -2,900.
Roger, we copy.
At the Earth, right out our front window. Houston, you're looking at our Delta H.
That's affirmative.
Program alarm.
Looking good to us, over.
The 1202. 1202.
Good radar data. Altitude now 33,500 feet.
Hal wasn't too far off.
I suspect that Hal may be just about right by the time
Doug
Ward
program alarm.
Relays that to us, so he's probably a few
That's
seconds
a thought.
Behind.
Yeah.
Roger, we got you. We're going at alarm.
Roger, 330.
6+25, throttle down. 6+25, throttle down.
Roger, copy. 6+25.
We're still go, altitude 27,000 feet.
Same alarm, and it appears to come up when we have a 1668 up.
Roger, copy.
What's this alarm, Wally?
It's a go case that
Eagle,
just
Houston,
apparently
we'll
some
monitor your Delta
sound beautifully.
Function that's coming up on the computer as
Delta
a verb.
Delta H looks good now.
Roger, Delta H is looking good to us.
A verb-noun combination, no problem, as I see it.
Throttle down on time.
Roger, copy,
throttle down.
Throttle
down. Better in the simulator.
Right.
They say it's better than the simulator. That's consoling.
Things look real close.
Crowds around this country and all over the world are watching this, listening to these communications.
Altitude now 21,000 feet,
just
still
as
looking
close
very
as
good.
We are. This is the International Arrivals Building, Kennedy Airport, with a big display board there. They
velocity
see these
down
pictures.
Now to 1,200 feet per second.
You're looking great,
this is Disneyland in California.
Okay, I'm still on flu, so we may tend to lose as we gradually pitch over. Let me try auto again now, see what happens.
Roger.
He's talking about the high gain antenna.
Okay, looks like it's holding.
Roger, we got
good
data.
Makes the job easier.
They're down to just 14 miles to go in 4.5 minutes.
7 minutes, 30 seconds into the burn.
4.5 minutes left in this era.
Altitude 16,300 feet.
Oh, boy.
This great the way the communications
Houston,
is working.
Descent
this.
To fuel to monitor, over.
Altitude
13,005.
Velocity
9,100
feet per second.
Made it, switch over time, please, Houston. Roger, stand by. You're looking great at 8 minutes.
Correction on that velocity, now reading 760 feet per second.
It's the P-64.
760 feet per second on the way down. That's pretty slow for space flying.
It is. It's as slow as man has ever flown in space.
It sure is.
Fido says we're go. Altitude 9,200 feet.
830, you're looking great.
They're just about
descent rate 129
approaching
feet
high
second.
Gate.
We copy.
That's a 7,600 foot level. 1.4 miles high when they get down to a speed of 98 miles an hour, and they're just a little under 5 miles from the landing site. At that point, they can pitch forward, get a really good view of the landing site.
You're looking great. Coming up 9 minutes.
At that high gate.
We're now in the approach phase. Everything looking good.
As they're inside
the
high gate.
5,200 feet.
5,200 feet, less than a mile from the moon, sir.
Manual attitude control is good.
Roger, copy.
Altitude 4,200.
Houston, you're a go for landing, over.
Oh, great go.
Roger, understand. Go for landing. 3,000 feet. Sound alarm.
3,000 feet. Ooh. Go to landing, meaning they're on their spot, huh?
Roger, 1201 alarm. We're go. Same time. We're go.
2,000 feet. 2,000 feet. Into the ag. 47 degrees.
Roger.
47 degrees.
Listen to these communications, too. We're getting this readout perfect.
Eagle looking great. Your go.
Altitude 1600.
Oh, this is...
They've got a good look at their site now. Ooh. This is the critical time. They're going to hover. They're going to make a decision. Apparently, they're go,
Roger,
though.
1202. We copy it.
35 degrees. 35 degrees. 750. Coming down to 23.
700 feet, 21 down, 33 degrees.
Oh, the data is coming in beautiful.
100 feet, down to 19. 540 feet, down to 30, down to 15. And 400 feet, down to 9. Gate forward. 150 feet, down at 4. 30 and a half down. Okay, engine stop. ACA at a descent. Hose control, both autos, Houston engine command override off. Engine arm off.
We're home.
413 is in.
Man on the moon.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Houston,
Jeez.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
Ooh. Oh, boy.
Thank you.
You're looking good here.
What?
Okay, we're going to be busy for a minute. After I'm on, take care of the I'll get this bus prepared.
Wally, say something. I'm speechless.
I'm just trying to hold on to my breath. That is really something.
Very smooth touchdown.
Kind of nice to be aboard on this one, isn't it?
You know, we've been wondering what this guy Armstrong or Aldrin would say. He stepped foot on the moon, which comes a little bit later now. And just to hear him do it, we're left here absolutely with dry mouths and speechless.
Looks like we're vending the ox
enough. Roger, Eagle, and you are stay for T1. Over. Eagle, you are stay for T1. Roger. And we see you vending the ox.
Roger.
It's a great simulation, what you can see there, if you could see us.
That little fly speck is supposed to be a lemur.
Gee, they must be in a perfect position, upright. We've heard no complaints about their position.
Just
they
the
landed
one.
Right.
Just a little dust. Even that concern was erased.
Wow. And there they sit on the moon. Just exactly nominal, wasn't it? Exactly as a flight plan all the way down. Man planning this thing on the surface of the Earth. I got it. We're done.
You know, it's funny, too.
Copy, 9:43.
Roger, we have it.
Yes, sir, I read Columbia, the high gate.
Roger, we read you 5-I, Columbia. He has landed Tranquility Base. Eagle is at Tranquility, over.
It's interesting that they're referring to it as Tranquility Base.
Buck, good show.
That was a confirmation to Columbia.
And people have the audacity to say there's not much new going on these days. I think that one's erased for a long time.
I'd like to know what some of those kids
the
we've talked to.
The next major stay, no stay, will be for the T2 event. That is at 21 minutes, 26 seconds after initiation of powered descent.
Columbia went up telemetry command reset to reacquire on the high gain.
Copy out.
This is a 9-minute period that they have in which they could, under certain phasing conditions, take off again and make re-rendezvous within two orbits of the nominal.
Yes, sir.
But they're not, they now have the stay for that period, so they're apparently not even considering leaving again at this time.
We have an unofficial time for that touchdown of 102 hours, 45 minutes, 42 seconds, and we will update that.
Time, which will be in the history books
Eagle,
forever.
Houston, you loaded R2 wrong. We want 10254.
I'd like to know what those kids who were kind of poo-pooing this thing are saying right at this moment. I'd like to know what they thought in those moments when our mouths were in our throats. How can anybody turn off of a world like this? They had quite a bit of tolerance in that landing speed. They could have gotten up to almost 7 miles an hour, 6.8 miles an hour. The struts are made to withstand that. But they came in apparently right on.
You heard those.
Buzz, this is Houston. Radio check and verify TV circuit breaker in.
Roger, TV circuit breaker's in. Base 5 clear.
Roger. We got a good picture, huh? There's a great deal of contrast in it, and currently it's upside down on our monitor, but we can make out a fair amount of detail.
Okay, would you verify the position the opening I ought to have on the camera?
Stand by.
There's that foot coming down.
There he is. Yeah. There's a foot coming down the steps.
Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
Okay, I just checked getting back up to that first step. That hasn't collapsed too far, but it's adequate to get back up.
Roger, we copy.
That's a pretty good little jump.
So there's a foot on the moon, stepping down on the moon. If he's testing that first step, he must be stepping down on the moon at this point.
Buzz, this is Houston. F2, 1/160th second for shadow photography on the sequence camera.
Okay.
I'm at the foot of the ladder. The lamb footbeds are only dressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches, although the surface appears to be very, very fine-grained as you get close to it. It's almost like a powder. Ground mass is very fine.
Boy, look at those pictures. Wow. It's a little shadowy, but he said he expected that in the shadow of the lunar module. Armstrong is on the moon, Neil Armstrong, 38-year-old American, standing on the surface of the moon on this July 20th, 1969.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
I think that was Neil's quote. I didn't understand it.
No, one small step for man, but I didn't get the second phrase. Some one of our monitors here at our space headquarters is able to hear that. We'd like to know what it was.
The surface is fine and powdery. I can pick it up loosely with my toe. It does adhere in fine layers, like powdered charcoal, to the and sides of my boot.
His quote was,
in,
that's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
I can't see the footprints of my boots and the treads in the fine sandy particles.
Neil, this is Houston. We're copying.
Oh, thank you, television, for letting us watch this one.
Isn't this something? 240 miles, 1,000 miles out there in the moon, and we're seeing this history being made.
There seems to be no difficulty in moving around as we suspected. It's even perhaps easier than the simulations of 1/6G that we performed in various simulations on the ground. Absolutely no trouble to walk around.
Gee, that's good news.
The descent engine did not leave a crater of any size. It has about 1 foot clearance on the ground. We're essentially on a very level place here. I can see some evidence of rays emanating from the descent engine, but very insignificant amount.
Hmm. To hurry up and fix this.
Now we're getting a negative picture back. Switch to negative polarity.
Are we ready to bring down the camera?
I'm all ready. I think it's 2 miles squared away in good shape. Okay.
That's Armstrong.
You'll have to pay out all the LEC. It looks like it's coming out nice and evenly.
That's the equipment conveyor, that tether line.
It's dark here in the shadow and a little hard for me to see, but I have good footing. I'll work my way over into the sunlight here without looking directly into the sun.
I don't know where in the Houston converter or where this picture has gone to negative polarity, but we hope we get it fixed shortly. At least we can make out the figure of Neil Armstrong there.
Unofficial time on the first step, 109.
Okay, I think you're pulling the wrong one. I'm ready to pull it down now. There was still a little bit left in the... Okay, don't hold it quite so tight. Okay?
As we said, this is this is like a clothesline. I'm going to bring down a sequence camera now for pictures, and then a little later on in this.
Looking up at the lamp, I'm standing directly in the shadow now, looking up at both in the windows, and I can see everything quite clearly. The light is sufficiently bright, backlighted into the front of the lamp, that everything is very clearly visible.
So man's first words, Neil Armstrong's first words.
Okay, I'm gonna be changing it.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. He found the bottom step of the ladder slightly awry, but says it gives no difficulty in climbing back up to the lunar module when they complete this walk. He's found the surface far more powdery than they had anticipated. He's sinking in by about an eighth of an inch. You see his footprints in the fine particles, lunar dust adhering to his boot. No difficulty in moving around, easier than the simulations on Earth. He has about 25 minutes of activity here alone on the moon's surface, testing the environment. Moving around like this, taking a good look at the lunar module, which he's given us a check on. Seems to be in good shape. Very little scoring of the moon's surface by the descent propulsion system engine. The pads settled nicely, but not very deeply into this fine powdery sand, or fine powdery surface of the moon. Apparently, it's in good position for to provide the platform for takeoff, or we have heard something about that by now from him.
The surgeon says that
camera installed on the ICU bracket.
The surgeon says the crew is doing well. Data is good, crew is doing well.
And I'm still in the LEC on the secondary stud.
That would seem to indicate that they're not overexerting, I gather.
That's good news.
They're not
using
too much oxygen, or they're not too much heat for the cooling system.
Another one of our concerns erased. The fact that there isn't that much work, they're not stressing.
I'll step out and take some of my first pictures here.
Four still pictures. It's not the sequence camera, which I've placed in the
radio loud and clear. Let's see, get some pictures and the contingency sample.
I think that the flight plan actually called for him to take the contingency sample first and then the pictures. As I recall all of my reading of the plan up to now, the contingency sample went first.
35 and a half minutes of PLSS time expended now.
Confirmed too that they're on a very level place there, which is good. Ben was partly because of his own skill in making that manual landing after it looked like they were coming down in a very rough area.
You know, it may be that Neil elected not to gather up a contingency sample because he feels there's no contingency here. He's showing great confidence that they'll do everything they intend to do.
It very well could be.
This is Houston. Do you copy about the contingency sample, over?
All right, you're going to get to that just as soon as I finish the picture series.
Well, he kind of twisted the order around a little bit. You may be right, Wally, as to what's in his mind, because the contingency sample really is superfluous if they go on with the rest of the walk and get the full samples, the 100 pounds or so of rock, and the documented samples of rock, in which they identify rock by rock, where they got it, and picture where they got it, and all that sort of thing. Although Newell's kind of shaking his head there about that. I think Newell Trask wants that contingency sample first, just like I said in the flight plan. I want to be sure he gets that pocket full of surface rock.
Make sure we get something.
I have an idea we're going to get everything we want.
I wouldn't be surprised.
It's just going so beautifully.
The moving around and the exertion that they're showing in doing that, or that Neil's showing so far, is, of course, the great thing that they've learned already.
And okay, you're going to get the contingency sample there.
Now Aldrin's been bugging him for it. The man is going to get tired of those kibitzers in a minute and get them up to the contingency sample just to quiet them. Nag, nag, nag.
He stepped out of the field of view. I wonder what he's up to now.
This little sort of bag on a sharp rim that he's dragging with along with an extension handle across the surface, and he's finding as he reports there that it's hard to get it to dig in.
It has a stark beauty all its own. It's like much of the high desert of the United States. It's different, but it's very pretty out here.
Very pretty.
Well, it's the first compliment the moon's had.
A lot of the rock samples out here, the hard rock samples, have what appear to be vesicles in the surface.
Appear to be what, Newell?
Vesicles.
Also, I'm looking at one now that appears to have some sort of phenocrysts.
Phenocrysts, typical of volcanic rocks.
Houston, roger that.
Push down. Got it? Now
Not all the way in. Push. There you go.
Engine disable is in the pocket. My oxygen is 81%. I have no flags and I'm in minimum flow.
This is Houston, or Roger Neal.
Okay, I got the camera going at one frame a second.
Neil, yes, we are getting a TV picture. Neil, this is Houston. We're getting a picture. You're not in at the present time. We can see the bag on the LEC being moved by Buzz, though. Here you come into our field of view.
Hey, look at the bounding step.
Let me move that over the hatch
for you. Okay, ready for me to come out?
Yeah, just
stand by a second. I'll move this over the handrail. Talk about being super casual. Yeah. Boy, it looks like fun, doesn't it? It doesn't get too
okay.
casual.
All right, that's got it. Are you ready?
All set.
I almost thought that was a simulation. He was moving so fast.
Okay, you saw what difficulties I was having. I'll try to watch your bliss from underneath here.
Aldrin about to emerge, apparently, from the spacecraft. And Armstrong's going to try to help guide him from below. Said he'd watch his PLIS, his portable life support system, as he climbs out so it doesn't hit the top of the hatch.
Okay, your PLIS looks like it's clear and okay. The toes are about to come over the seal. Okay, now drop your PLIS down. There you go, you're clear. And laterally, you're good. Got an inch clearance on top of your PLIS.
Okay, you need a little bit of arching of the back to come down. How far are my feet from the
Okay,
edge?
You're right at the edge of the porch.
Okay, back in from... Small little foot movement, porch, arching in the back, moment comes up and clears the bulkhead without any trouble at all.
Looks good.
Minutes PLSS time expended.
It's 45 minutes out of a total of
Neil,
4 hours.
Neil, this is Houston. Based on your camera transfer with the LEC, do you foresee any difficulties in SRC transfer over?
Negative. SRC is a sample rock container, the box.
The sample return containers, the rock boxes that Capcom...
Now I want to back up and partially close the hatch.
In case anybody comes by, they want the door closed.
This camera angle makes those steps look like they're vastly higher than they really
Making
are.
Sure not to lock it on my way up.
Particularly good thought.
What did he say? I'll make sure not to lock it.
Okay, I'm on the top step, and I can look down over the RCU and landing gear pad. It's a very simple matter to hop down from one step to the next.
There he comes.
Yes, I'm on it. Be very comfortable, and walking is also very comfortable. You you've got three more steps, and then a long one.
Watch that last step.
I guess he expected that strut to compact a little bit more, but as a result, it's a long step from
there. Okay, I'm gonna leave that 1 foot up there, and both hands down about the fourth rung up. There you go.
Welcome home.
And now we have two Americans on the moon.
A little more. Another inch. There, you got it? That's a good step. Yep.
About
a 3-footer.
3-foot first step, but 1/6 gravity, and look at that. It's like being on a...
Beautiful view. Isn't that something? Magnificent sight out here. Magnificent desolation.
It's like walking on a trampoline.
Oh, my.
Aldrin's first words.
The PLSS is nominal.
Beautiful view.
Consumables.